as when you admire something, you become beloved. Avas HaTorah. Oh, there's stories and stories to describe as Avas HaTorah. He once said, he doesn't have a Yitzhar to battle. I'm sure in his younger years he certainly did, I can attest to it. But later on in life he said, I don't have a Yitzhar to battle. That's where HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave me my machia. That was my Yitzhar. He had such a tremendous love for Torah. It was the most enjoyable thing he had in life. He used to speak to children cheder and talk about the sweetness of Torah. I remember at the Sima Shas a few years ago in Binyoni Oma, he spoke in English, and he said, Hadron Allah, Talmud Bavli. There are no sweeter words than that to say, we finish Shas. Zisator, Zisator. I often ask him, how can I help you? Nebuch, he wasn't a well person. How can I help you? He'd tell me, sit and learn. Keep the world afloat. Torah, Torah, Torah. That was his motto. Avas HaBrias. As I said earlier, Oz V'Hodr Levusha. Oz refers to the ambition and drive. For Hodr, the Rambam says, and that passage in Mishlei, Hodr refers to the beauty of Midas Tovus. Rav Nosson Tzvi was par excellence in Midas Tovus ben Ono Chavera. A tremendous love of people, a natural liking. His friends of the past cantor Nachmovel, and they all said the Pesach Echad, he was so well loved and well liked. I remember when he came there to Israel, we went to Malapim at the airport. This is 1960. I went along, and there were many, many, many classmates to bid him farewell at the airport, and literally, they were crying and moved to tears. Because their dear, dear friend of Nosson Tzvi was partying. Avas HaBrias. During the Shiva, one of the younger Avreichim told me that when he was about 21 years old, his father wanted to go into Shiduchim, he wanted to continue learning. So he figured, last from Nosson Tzvi and Eitz, what should he do? He came to Nosson Tzvi, he mentioned the girl's name, where she came from, and he said to the boy, come back to me in 2 hours, I'll tell you the answer. He came back 2 hours later. He told me the boy, he doesn't know what Nosson Tzvi, he suspects he's Mavara about this girl. He has 6,000 Tamidim, and he took off time, most likely, to check into this girl. And he told the boy, go into the Shidduch. And he did. He barely knew the boy, a slight acquaintance, one of them in Yeshiva, one of 6,000, I mean, he loved them all, but how well did he know him? He said, go into the Shidduch, and he talked, invested in the Shidduch, he did get engaged, he got married in Chutz L'Aretz, and he came back to the Shiva several months later, and he came to Nosson Tzvi asking, can I join the Kola? But Nosson Tzvi didn't take everybody into the Kola. But he said to this fresh younger man, you're accepted. And the younger man was baffled. Why was he being accepted with no resistance? Rav Nosson Tzvi said right in the spot, yeah, of course you're accepted. It's because of me you got married. He remembered this younger man from several months earlier that asked him the question. He recognized the face, he remembered the answer, and he said, it's my fault that you're married. Of course you're accepted. That's Avas HaBrias. To barely have a kesher with a talmid and to remember every step of the conveyance and the relationship between that new man. And this goes story after story after story. He was so perceptive in the needs of the talmidim. Once Rosh Hashanah, all the boys walked around, the thousands walked around to wish a good yard to Rosh Hashanah, literally thousands. It took at least an hour till the base matrix emptied out. And one boy was walking by and Rosh Hashanah stopped him. Held up the line of the hundreds waiting to say good yontif, and he said a few encouraging words to the boy, good yorg, say some toive. And they asked him afterwards, why did you stop this boy? He said, this boy must have a problem. He wasn't dressed like he was dressed. His shirt button was open, his tie was not neat. There must be something on his mind. He He was in a mashbir. He was having troubles at that point. And Nosson Tzvi chapted his perception of human nature, the needs of the other person. Once there was a reich, Nebuch had to go to Chutz Lords with his wife, or his wife in the treatment. And Nosson Tzvi told him, be sure to call me up once in 2 weeks. Once in 2 weeks, they had to go for a year. And in the beginning, they called up every 2 weeks. And then a few weeks passed, he got no phone call from Nosson Tzvi. And then shortly after, the Gaman gets a phone call from Nosson Tzvi himself. Why didn't you call me last week? How he held Kop, how he held Cheshbon, the 6,000 Talmidim. And remember this Abrech who had to go with his wife. Story after story after story. Avos and Brios. It really made a difference for him. And when I think about his Kibbutz Avraham, we had... We had a kviyas every Friday morning to go to my mother. She'd be well. The nachas she had from him. The incredible amount of mitzvahs kibbutzim, he was zeicher shlobe kavana. Mitzvahs benon chavero, you became without kavana. Rashi says in Chumash, if you lose a penny and a poor man finds it, you get the mitzvah of stalker. You had no kavana to do the mitzvah. As long as the mitzvah was achieved, you became the mitzvah by mitzvahs benon chavero. But only mokin tzvichas kavana. Benon chavero ain't tzvichas kavana. The amount of nachas ruach he gave to our mother. Just his mere existence as the great Rosh Hashiva of a mere. But he was Marsa Nefesh every Friday morning. He could barely walk steps, and he walked up the steps, and he had to be schlepped up the steps, and refused to have my mother come to him to visit him. He insisted he must visit our mother. He came Friday after Friday after Friday after Friday with Mesiras Nefesh, with no koyches at all. There was an incident not too long ago, I remember this. He had to go to Chasen and B'nai Brak. And he came back right after the chuppah because he had another chassan in Yerushalayim, and he felt that he had to go back to the chassan in Bnei Brak. B'nai Chaver, he felt the person would have a lot of idud, encouragement to go back, as difficult as it was. The mother said to him, how can you go back? How can you go back? We dropped the mother off at her house. A few minutes later, she gets a phone call. I was in the Cairo with my brother, my Sachman Roch, and my sister-in-law. My sister-in-law called my mother and asked me, Ma, Rav Nosson asked for shoes to go to the Chasana. The grace of Rosh Hashiva, understanding that our mother sensed she didn't want him to go, asked, Ma, can I go to the Chasana? A lesson for all of you youngsters here. Speaking of Kibbutz Avraham, how did Rav Nosson Tzvi have this courage to see the goodness of every person? There's an incredible Chaya Odom in Hilchos Kibbutz Avraham that says that a son and a daughter as well is mechuyev, they see their father as achad bedor, as one of the greatest people in the generation. Every child has an obligation to see the father as gadol bedor, gadol bedor. How can that be? All our fathers are gadol Yisrael, gadol bedor. So our Rebbe Chaim Shlomis used to say, yes. Every person, without an exception, has a certain trait, quality, that he excels in beyond anyone else. It's a son's job to find that quality. It's not easy, but it's there. That's how Nosson Tzvi felt about every individual. He had the knack and the keen sense of seeing the goodness in the wickedness of people. He's such a kernel ayin tova. He's able to see the goodness. He's able to see between the lines. Ah, here's your maile. And he was able to blend it and to groom it. There was a bacher who was matzliach in many yeshivas, and he was contemplating coming back to America, dropping his learning. It just wasn't going, a true story. And he said he was going to give himself one more try at it. He came to Mir Yeshiva, he came to Nosson Tzvi. He didn't do so well on the fahair, on the exam. Rav Nosson Tzvi asked, do you really want to learn? He says, yes, I absolutely do. So Rav Nosson Tzvi took him in. A few weeks passed, and he saw the bacher and asked, how's it going? The bacher says, I don't have a chavrus in the afternoon. It's not going well. Rav Nosson Tzvi said to him, come to me Sunday afternoon. and we'll talk about it and see what we can do. The Bachri came. He said he still doesn't have Harusa. And Nosson Tzvi said, come, we'll learn today. And they learned. After the afternoon setting, Nosson Tzvi said, come back tomorrow, Monday. He came back and they learned Monday. And then he said, come back Tuesday. They learned the entire winter's man. The Shvach and Bocher, who almost gave up hope on his learning career, learned with Nosson Tzvi the whole man. And today, he's a very choshev makachir in North America. He would have been lost totally, but Nosson Tzvi took him under his wing and learned with the Shvach and Bocher day after day after day, and groomed him to a choshev makachir. And this is one of hundreds of stories, hundreds of lives that we've saved. The encouragement is to give the Bachim who were down. The chavrusas he set up with the Bachim who needed the help. I remember 40 years ago, he used to raise money behind the scenes to pay Avrichim to learn the Shvach HaBachim. He helped the young man with the Parnasa, and he gave the Shvach HaBachim encouragement and satisfaction and growth in learning. The Olam Haba he's going to get for that time after time after time. Totally voluntary. To raise money, and say he was in his 20s, to pay him the light with their Panhapam and Panasa, to save a Bacher. It was his natural instinct to help the underdog. Chazal tell us, when you're looking for a Rebbe, what should you look for? The pasuk says, "In domem b'chol kamachal l'kim tzvokas yivakshei Torah m'piu." If you find someone who resembles a malach, make him your rabbi. I once heard Shem Rav Gifter, "What's a malach?" He said, "Rav Gifter, I don't know what a malach is, but one thing I do know: malach has one job, one mission. If you find a rabbi." That's totally brought to his Talmidim, totally given to his Talmidim, nothing else on his mind, he's who you should select as a Rebbe. Ma'ach Lekim Tzvokas. Rav Nosson Tzvi Zichron Bracha was a true Ma'ach Lekim Tzvokas. He had nothing on his mind but the Atzlacha of his Talmidim, but the Atzlacha of Mir Yeshiva. When he took over the leadership 20-odd years ago, there's 1,000-plus Talmidim with one big base medrash. Over his mantle, he built the yeshiva to 6,000 talmidim, the biggest yeshiva in Klal Yisrael since the Churban Beis HaMikdash. The sick, ill person achieved godless 6,000 talmidim, with tens of buildings, beautiful manifests in Brachfeld, Beitar, Ramat Shlomo, almost single-handedly. How did he do it? Like we opened up with, Dai Vahoser, he never gave up. He knew he could do it. If you try hard enough, you succeed. Indeed, that's probably the most unique facet of Nosson Tzvi, his Mesiris Nefesh. The Gemara says in Brachas, B'bnei Mad Doros Hashonu Zochel Anisim, but Doros Hachonu Lo Zochel Anisim. Why were early generations open to miracles and later generations not? So the Mori answers, because early generations were Moisik Nefesh and a Kiddush Hashem. And the Mori describes him, Mesiris Nefesh doesn't mean to jump in the Kiddush Hashem. Mesiris Nefesh is to work for the right cause and put on your coat as a Nefesh, we'll all sacrifice at whatever's expense. With that, Yuzochid Nisim. That was Nosson Tzvi. He was Moisik Nefesh for Kiddush Hashem, for Kvod Shamayim. And that he was Zochid to Nisim Gluyim, to achieve what he achieved.